AI filmmaking just became incredibly simple. Google's Nano Banana launched just a few days ago, and it's unlocked a whole new range of possibilities for AI filmmaking. It is currently the world's best AI image editing model, and it's especially good with subject consistency. It allows you to take any character or subject and edit them into whichever way you wish, while maintaining the core appearance. You can then use these subject consistent images as start and end frames to create consistent videos. Today I'm gonna show you the exact workflow I use to create this film, and by the end of this tutorial, you'll know step by step how to create AI films using techniques that most people don't even know of. Let's dive in. So the first step in this filmmaking workflow would be to create your story and your sequence. So you can just create a rough draft like this one. It doesn't have to be super detailed. If you can see my example here, it's just basically six scenes or six sequences. But this is important so you can get into the flow later once you start creating the images and animating them. Now, you can ask AI to write the story for you, but it's more fun and you would get for sure better results and less generic results if you do it yourself, or at least have an initial idea of what you already want, and then you can just ask AI's help to refine it. Now, once you have your rough story draft in place, in my case, it's the magic banana, then you can move to creating the establishing shot. So the establishing shot is usually gonna be the very first frame of your AI film, and it's what's gonna set the overall aesthetic and mood of the film you'll be making. So it's crucial that you get the aesthetic and subject you want here, since Nano Banana will be basing the overall look and feel of its edits based on the establishing shot that you give it. So you can use any image generation tool you want here. I prefer to use Midjourney because it provides the best aesthetics for my taste, but you're free to use any AI image generation tool that you're comfortable with. So since I have a specific character that I want to use in the film, in this case me, Banana Man, then I use Midjourney's OmniReference to generate my establishing shot. So what I did was I just went here to OmniReference and dragged a photo of myself like this, and then input my prompt. So the prompt I used here was generated using my Midjourney prompt generator, but you can basically get away with just using simple prompts. So here's an example. Let's just input medium shot of a man holding a magic glowing banana. And as you can see, Midjourney generated aesthetic images using this simple prompt and my reference image. Although, yeah, they don't necessarily look exactly like me. And I think Midjourney is trying to tell me something with this forehead thing. Like, is it really that bad, Midjourney? I don't think so. Come on, man. I've generated so much images using you, and this is how you do me. Very sad. But anyway, it's super crucial that you get the aesthetics and look of the subject in your establishing shot. If you can see here, I generated so many iterations and images just to get my establishing shot that I was happy with. And even when I got what I wanted here, I still tried doing many more iterations. And I think I chose this one as a backup, which I actually also used as the end frame, actually, for the story. Now, you can also use Nano Banana to create the image. You can either start from scratch or feed it a reference image. But as you can see here, it didn't necessarily create an image that's as aesthetic as Midjourney. So I ended up just using this. So once you're happy with your establishing shot, then it's time to open up Nano Banana. So there's a free and paid way to access this model. So the free way is by using LM Arena. You can just choose direct chat and click generate images, and you will already see that Nano Banana is selected here by default. And you can also search for it using the model search dropdown here. So you can already start generating images through here. Since this is free, you will very quickly come across the usage limit. But what I've heard is you can just simply start a new incognito tab, then go to LM Arena again, And you can just keep on doing that. So every time you run out of usage limits, open up a new incognito window and then use Nano Banana again. But since I have a paid plan on Google, then I'll be using it directly on Gemini by selecting Flash here and then selecting Create Images. And then I can already start generating images using chat. Now, we've had AI image editors before. I remember when ChatGPT first released their AI image generation and editing model, and it just went viral and everyone was talking about it. And more recently, there's also Flux Kontext that performs better than ChatGPT. But the thing is, Nano Banana just achieves a whole new level of consistency. To give you an example, here's an image edit request I made using ChatGPT. So I inputted a picture of myself and I said, make the hair of the man long. And it gave me back this image. So yes, it looks similar to me, I guess, but it's definitely not me. And it kept the shirt color and everything, but still, it's not good enough for most, if not all, of the image editing cases. Now we have Flux Kontext. So I use this via Comfy UI. And I fed the same image and gave the same prompt, make the hair of the man long, and it gave me back this. A bit better than ChatGPT, but you can still see that it did change the image. So it changed the texture of my skin and a few of my facial features. So it's not an exact copy or an exact edit, right? Now here's what Nano Banana did. I mean, just look at that. That's exactly the same image I provided, but my hair is just now more luscious and long. I actually had hair like this before. I'm thinking of going back to it, but my girlfriend might break up with me. So if I end up homeless and shooting videos on the street over the next couple of weeks, then you know what happened. Anyway, so now you see the results from the different image editing models. Now we go into using Nano Banana itself to create our storyboard images. So step three is to take your establishing shot and think of an action you want to happen moments into the future. In my case, since in the video I want me to take a bite of the banana and get transported to a different setting, then if I think about this in keyframes, then in images, it would be one image of me looking at the already peeled banana and then the banana already having a bite on it. So I peel it first and then I take a bite. So that's exactly what I did. So I gave Nano Banana the establishing shot and I gave it a very simple conversational prompt. I said, the man is holding the peeled banana upright. And this is what it gave me. So notice the difference from this. The banana's already peeled, and the establishing shot. You can see that it kept the exact same facial features I have, and it just changed the banana from being unpeeled to peeled. I then said, the man takes a small bite from the banana. The man is chewing. So now, it gave me this image. You can see that the banana already had the bite taken out of it, and that my facial expression changed. Now, what's next after that is, once I take a bite out of the banana, I should be transported to a mystical forest and my outfit should change. So I asked Nano Banana to make that image for me. So I gave it this prompt, since I did use my AI image prompt writing assistant. And by the way, if you want to learn how to create assistants for any task, then make sure to check out this video over here. I'll also link it down in the comments. So I gave it this prompt to change the man to a surprised expression, to change his attire from a black t-shirt into an olive green vest, and then it gave me this image. So an important tip here is that if Nano Banana doesn't really give you the image that you want, then you can just take the last image that you like the result of, copy it, and then start a new chat, and then prompt from here. I usually found that that solves any issues I encounter. So I just did this a couple of times where I have the new image and I think of the action that I want to happen next, and then just keep on generating the images that are next to that. So these were all the images that I came up with. So we have establishing shot, peeled banana, bitten banana, in the forest, far view of the forest, and then zoom in. Then I got into the spaceship, and then the underwater world, and then back to the kitchen. So step four is to animate these keyframe images. Now that we have all of the images, it's time to use an AI video tool that has first frame and last frame capabilities. I used Midjourney since I like the smoothness and consistency of its video generation. And for me, it's just the most cost-effective and fast option out there. Plus, I already have a paid plan for it. There are a lot of new tools now in the market with this kind of capability, like Runway or Kling, and even some free options. Now, what you have to do is to use your establishing shot as the first frame, and then the first keyframe image as the end frame, and describe what happens to the AI video model so that it can connect the dots. In this case, I gave my establishing shot as the starting frame. So I dragged it here and the first keyframe image as the ending frame. And then I just basically said, the man peels the banana. And Midjourney gave me these four results and I ended up going with this one. As you can see, a lot of them aren't perfect. This one has like a weird peeling motion. This one overall just looks weird, like the banana morphs around. So I ended up using this actually. So sometimes you have to go through different iterations to get the video that you want. And this applies to most of the AI tools. That's why I said that Midjourney is the most cost effective, because it kind of takes around a minute, maximum 2 minutes, to generate four sets of videos. And if you don't like what you get, then you can just generate again and the cost isn't that high. So once you're happy with that video, then you can move to creating the next one. The good thing is, since you use the ending frame as the first keyframe image, then what you can do is to create a new video, and then the end frame I used was a picture with a bite already taken out of the banana, and I just simply described, the man takes his first bite of the banana. So again, I selected what I want and then I just described the transition I want, and you can just rinse and repeat until you get the result that you want. And the bonus tip here also, if you're using Midjourney, is if you like the video, you can choose to extend it and add an ending frame, or just choose to extend it outright without adding an ending frame and see what happens. So if we try that for us, you can see it's now 8.9 seconds and it extended the video further. Since we didn't define a motion that we wanted, it just made us take another bite. But let's say you do like the results of this one and want to adjust your keyframes. You want to use the final frame of this extended video as the start frame of the next video. Then what you can simply do is download this video. Then you can go to final frame extractor tool like finalframe.ai and just input the video here. After it's done processing, then it's going to give you the final four frames of the video. And then you can just choose what you want here, click it, and then it will get downloaded. Now, once you've generated all of your video clips, then we can move to step five, which is the rough edit. So what you can do is to take all of your video clips and put them in an editor of your choice. In my case, I use DaVinci Resolve's free plan, but you can use whatever you're comfortable with. So you can just lay out all of the videos here in order. Let me do that quickly. So now that I have it laid out, then I can already see the sequence happening here. And it already looks good, but of course it's not perfect and there are some edits to be made. But the goal of step five is to just connect your different clips together and see how they look like. So once you're happy with your rough cut, then watch it again and start taking mental notes of the different sound effects and music you would need for your video. In my case, I wanted a biting sound whenever I took a bite from the banana, like here. I wanted a magical transition sound whenever I got transported to a new setting. So around here, also around here, right? And I wanted ambient music for the different settings I'm in. So forest music, spaceship music, and underwater music. And I also wanted an overall music track that fits the feel of the film. Step six is generating sound effects and music. So you can find a lot of royalty-free sound effects online, But the cool thing is you can also generate the sound effects and music yourself, which gives you way more creative freedom and flexibility because you're not just stuck with whatever sound effect and music you can find, but you can instead create it from scratch. So how I do this is by using 11 Labs. So if you go to 11 Labs and you go to Playground and Sound Effects, then you can see here that there are music libraries that you can search through, or you can create the sound effects yourself using this prompt chat box here below. So you can set it if you want the sound effects to loop. You can set the duration. In my case, I just leave it at auto for now. And then you can set the prompt influence. Now let's try generating sound effects. Let's say Christmas bells, since I love Christmas and I love Christmas music. So let's just go with Christmas bells. So you hit enter. You can see how many credits it will consume. So now it's generating. And once it's done, it will give you four options. So let's play the first one. All right. The second one. You see, it's not bad and it's ultimately flexible depending on what you prompt. And whatever you like, you can just click this download button here. And if you want to go through all of the sound effects you generated, you can just go to history here. And if we scroll down, you can even see the different sound effects I generated, like soft magical sound, ambient forest, ambient underwater sound, and so on. Now the last step is the final edit, where you basically take all of these sounds back to your video editor and input them on the timeline. And it would also be good to add whatever final touches like transitions and color corrections that you wish. So in this case, there's just a big difference with the video having the music. So you can hear the banana peeling, the bite, the transition sound effects, and so on. And I even added like video transitions as well, like that and that also. So it just kind of helps highlight the effects further. And there you go. That's the complete Nano Banana powered AI filmmaking workflow from start to finish. To recap, the steps are: number one, to draft out your story. Number two is to create your establishing shot. Number three is to create your storyboard images. Number four is to animate using first frame and last frame capabilities. Number five is to stitch the video clips together in a rough cut. Number six is to generate or source sound effects and music. And then seven is the final edit. The generative AI media field is on fire with all these new updates coming out, and I'm super excited to see what's coming next. And if you found this video helpful, please make sure to like and subscribe. I make AI tutorial videos like this every week, so please drop a comment below also and tell me what you'd like to learn next. And if you want to check out another comprehensive tutorial like this, where I teach you how to harness AI capabilities to the fullest, then make sure to check out this video.